Attention, ladies and gentlemen, are you ready to get started? Yes or yes? Oh, there we go. Well, let's get started so we can get some good food in you. We got some great presentations here tonight. We want to recognize excellence. My name is Nathan Osmond, and I'm going to be your MC here tonight. So we're very excited. We'd like to go ahead and, first of all, welcome and introduce some very special people here. We got Mayor Kurt Christensen from Salem City. Where is he? Mayor Christensen, right there. Good to see you. You're not you're having fun with me. Okay. We also got Mayor Mike Mendenhall from Spanish Fork City. All right. And of course, Senator Mike McKell is here with us. Where's Senator Mike McKell? Right here in the front. I love it. We're going to have him sing you a song on the piano here. No, it's good to see you here tonight. Thank you for being here. All right, we'd also like to recognize all of the city council and organizations who are here with us tonight. Let's give them all a big round of applause. Yeah. Love this energy, guys. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to start off with an invocation by Kevin Euler. If we can invite him to come up right now and start off the meeting on the right foot. Here we go.
Our Father in heaven, we give thanks this night for the opportunity that we have to gather. We are grateful, Father, for the community that we live in. We're thankful for the beauty that surrounds us. We're grateful for the snow that we got today and ask that thou would continue to bless us with more. We're thankful, Father in heaven, for the responsibilities which we hold and help us that we can carry them out to the best of our abilities. And we give thanks for the chamber and all that it does for our community and bless those who serve and who work, that they can be looked over and provided for. We give thanks, Father, for the military and our first responders who work each day to keep us safe and protected, and we're grateful for them. We ask a blessing on the food at this time, that it will do our bodies the good that we need, and we pray for these things in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thank you, Kevin. Before we start, we'd like to always kick off a great event like this with some patriotism. So if I could ask Rex Facer here to come up here, and he's going to lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
Will the audience please rise? Please join me in the pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you.
We're going to change up the program just a slight bit right now because we have Salem Mayor here. Mayor Kurt Christensen has to get back to the city council like tonight. Like he's got a duty he's got to take care of, guys. So what we're going to do is we're going to have him present one of the awards right now so that we can make sure he gets back there to the city council. So if we can invite our city, the mayor of Kurt Christensen here from Salem City. Let's give it up for Mayor Christensen. Yeah. Here he comes. Good to see you, brother.
I have a paper in my pocket, but I'm not going to read it. You guys all know the Mayor's Choice Award goes to Sterling and Cynthia Reeves. I've been able to work with him for 4 years now. He sits right next to me, but he's worked for 12 years, hard years for the city. And you guys have probably all got to know him, and he does a wonderful job. And there's one thing I want to tell you about Sterling. He makes the right choice. He'll sit by me, and we'll sit and chit-chat while people are talking. But I really appreciate his friendship and the time he spent. I think we don't realize he would go to Tennessee once a year, and then he'd go to Washington, D.C. once a year. It takes a lot of time. And you're visiting with people and promoting the power agency. And he did a wonderful job. And he's a friend, and I love him. And Salem's lucky to have him. And so I appreciate this. And that's who gets the award for the Mayor's Choice Award is Sterling and Cynthia. Those of you, Sterling did a great job in everything he did. I don't know how he got so many prizes for the golf tournament, but there had to be $10,000 worth every year. Everything he did was great. He did the memorial program. Everything was excellent. And I just really appreciate him. He was my pro tem mayor, and my pro tem mayor is now sick, and that's why I'm coming here, running back to the city council, because we have nobody to run the meeting in a few minutes. I went to the work session for a minute, but anyway, thank you, Sterling, for everything. Thank you for your friendship.
One more round of applause. Isn't that beautiful? I love that. Thank you again, Mayor Christensen, for being here. We appreciate that so much. We'd also like to ask the 2022 Chamber Board to stand, if they will. Let's recognize our board who's here tonight. Fantastic. All right. We got Randy Kaufman, our board chair here with RK Creative Studio. David Rowley from Rowley Associate, Rowley and Associates, Jesse Carden from Griffles, Rich Cope from Rich Cope Realty, Tanya Giesberg, did I say that right? Giesberg? Giesberg, I love that. All right, from Compassion Mobility, we got Brad Tanner from Triple T Heating, Cooling, and Plumbing, Jared Hales from Zions Bank, Kathleen Levitt from Lions Pride Insurance, Mike Rasmussen from Rasmussen Fine Jewelry, Brent Wall, Advanced Spinal Care, Shelly Jameson from S. Jameson Homes, Joe Allredge from Warner Construction, Candace Young from Hydro, Isaiah Price from Sophos Survival, Lillian Kump from Tabitha's Way, Mark Middlebrook from M-Tech, and last but not least, we got Lance Wilson from Lance Wilson State Farm. Let's give them all a big round of applause. You're in good hands with State Farm. Awesome. All right, ladies and gentlemen, hope you're enjoying your meals here tonight. Some good food out there, and we have some great dinner entertainment for you, everybody, tonight. We'd like to welcome here to the stage the Salem Hills High School Choir under the direction of Justin Bills. Let's make these guys feel like rock stars here tonight. Come on down, y'all. Oh, yeah. Salem Hills High School Choir. Thank you.
questions for another day. I think I know what you've been asking me. I think you know what I've been trying to say. I promise I would never leave.
We shall run and not be weary. They shall run. say on the Lord. Wait, wait on the Lord. Be strong and of good courage. Wait on the Lord. I say on the Lord. Wait, wait on the Lord. Be strong and of good courage. Wait on the Lord. I say on the Lord. Wait on the Lord. Be strong and of good courage. Wait on the Lord. I say on the Lord.
I say wait.
Awesome. As they're walking past your table, one more big round of applause, huh? Salem Hills High School Choir. Justin Bills, good job, brother. Man, I tell you, well, he's got them in tune. I love that. As an Osmond, I grew up singing tight harmonies, and I can respect what they just did up here, guys. And while I've got you here, I'd like to tell you about Amway and how it's changed my life. I'm just kidding. We're going to have some fun tonight. You guys already having fun? Yeah? Woo! I love Spanish Fork, guys. This is great. It's great to be back here with my old stomping grounds. I grew up here. My grandpa, Ken Pinniger, was he and my grandmother lived just down the street from this place. So we spent a lot of time as kids. And, of course, the first place I lived as a newlywed was right here in good old Spanish Fork. And now I live in the other fork. See, yeah, we go from fork to fork. But it's good to be here. We're excited right now because we're going to introduce right now Jesse Carden. That's right, the past president of the Chambers here with us. Jesse, will you come up right now? Let's give it up for Jesse. Yeah.
This is nice to be back together. After last year, we did a video chamber gala. It didn't have the same feel. So take it in, you know, enjoy that, you know, we get to be back together. I'm excited that we're here tonight. As everyone is aware, the last couple of years as businesses has probably been the easiest time in business in the history of business. It's been hard. It's been difficult. But as a chamber, as a community, we stuck together. We made sure that we helped each other out. We found opportunities to support one another when, you know, we heard of a business struggling, or if we knew someone in the community was looking for opportunities, we made it happen. That's what the chamber is about. That's what this community is about, is helping each other and making sure that we are focused on the success of the group, not just on ourselves. So, as the past chamber president, I get the opportunity to talk about those who are leaving the board this year. So some of them aren't with us, so I'm gonna start with them. Amy, Brenda, Mike, Angie, and Nicole are some people that are leaving the chamber board. So let's give them a round of applause. Many people in this room, whether they are on the board currently, have been on the board, they know that there's a lot of work, there's a lot of effort that goes into it. And then I want to recognize two individuals that are with us. The first one, this individual stepped up when we didn't have enough board members, was asked, hey, we need some help, and can you help us? And they did it. Even though they had a lot of insert word stuff going on in their home business and life during a pandemic. So we want to recognize Mercedes. Come on up.
Recognize your team.
So. I couldn't have done this without my team. So will my team come up here for the picture?
Yeah.
And my husband. And my husband. Awesome. We're like half the crowd. Thank you.
Thanks, guys.
All right, and the next person who is leaving us with us tonight is also our past president, Wendy Osborne. Wendy led the chamber during the thick of the pandemic and made sure that we kept events going. So let's give a round of applause to Wendy. With that, I just want to say thank you. Thank you for your support of the chamber. Thank you to the city representatives, the city of Spanish Fork, the city of Salem, for letting us use the venues, letting us use time and different things in those locations. Thank you to the businesses that continue to support the Chamber of Commerce, because without that support, the chamber doesn't exist. So thank you, and thank you for making 2021 what it was.
Right. We're going to throw the hammer down. I mean the gavel down. Here we go. We're going to give away some gavels right now. This is tradition right here. The highlight of the night, the 2021 Spanish Fork Salem Chamber of Commerce Awards. And this award is tradition. Isn't that right, David? David Rowley, by the way, give a big round of applause. This guy has done so great organizing this. And it takes a team, doesn't it? So the first award is going to be the outgoing chair gavel holder. And the name is Jesse Carden. Jesse, come get your, this will hold the gavel.
He didn't bring the gavel.
Well deserved. Okay, the next one is going to receive the gavel, and this is the board chair. Say it again.
Randy Kaufman.
Randy Kaufman, right here. Yeah. So you call this to order. Here comes the hammer. Remember that old rap song? Indeed, myself here. Okay. All right, let's see. We got the new outgoing board member recognition right here. We already did that one. Okay. So we're going to do the Chamber Excellence Award. Now this award, the Chamber Excellence Award is reserved for a person or organization that not only embodies what it means to be a chamber member, but also one who stands out as having made significant contributions to the cause of economic progress and vitality within our community. This is a great award. And we're going to present it to...
Take your spot for a second.
You got it.
I'm excited to give this award because this person has no idea that it's happening. I've talked about the pandemic a lot. I don't want to keep harping on it. But without good leadership, we don't survive that as a city, as a community. This person not only owns businesses in the area, has lived here their whole lives, and also has made sure that the business community was taken care of. That we led out by making sure that many businesses in here survived with PPE because they made it sure that the businesses within the community were provided with that. One of the things that they did in their service was to ensure that last year during Christmas time, I guess 2020, that businesses or citizens of the city of Spanish Fork were able to have some vouchers that they could go and shop local. And they can make sure to keep the money within the city, but also to make sure that the citizens were taken care of and the businesses were taken care of. This is a drop in the bucket of what this person has done for the business community in Spanish Fork. Without this person's dedicated service, we don't have the business community that we currently enjoy. Over 16 years of service, whether on city council or as a mayor, as fiesta days, as what, I don't, we have a lot of things we can talk about. It's my pleasure to give the Chamber of Lexington's floor to former Mayor Steve Lason. So while we were cleaning the chamber offices, or doing some light dusting, we'll call it, we came upon this, let's call it a trophy. Let's call it that. It says the Spanish Fork Salem Chamber of Commerce, but on the back it says, bound and determined. And you'll see two little kids trying to get up on a horse. And without leadership, like we're talking about tonight, those kids don't get up on that horse. Our business community doesn't do what it's doing. So thank you.
Congratulations, Steve. I tell you, what a great honor. You know, my mother and he went to school. My mother was a cheerleader at Spanish Fork High, and they were in class together. How fun, Steve. Congratulations on a job well done, brother. One more hand. I tell you, 16 years as a public servant. That's amazing. All right, now we're going to get down to the business of the year award. This is a big one, you guys. The business of the year award is voted on by fellow members of the chamber. The nominees come from the 12 businesses who were awarded business of the month during the year. Nominees have shown commitment to personal or professional excellence, business growth, community involvement, and leadership. And we're going to hand right here. Randy, come on down. You're going to announce this one. This is going to be a good one. I'm excited for this.
Oh, great. No pressure. So I have the privilege. Sorry, I wrote it all down. So, oh, yeah, lower the mic. Okay.
Mic drop.
So I have the privilege of awarding this to Dickerson Automotive. I've known Todd my whole pretty much career in the chamber, so it's been over 10 years that I've known him and of his business and his family, and they are a great asset to our community. Not only do they provide a great service, but they service in meaning what they do for their business, but they provide a service to people in need of vehicles. Without vehicles, people can't work or get to kids to school and do the things. And so I gotta make sure, because I'm nervous, so I won't say it right if I Wills with heart. I should know this. I helped you design the logo, right? So I'm grateful for Dickerson Automotive. I'm grateful, you know, Todd's been on the board. He served as chair. His office manager, Briley, is a big part as well. So I'm honored to award this to Dickerson Automotive tonight.
Congratulations. I love award ceremonies. Aren't these fun? You know, my wife, she told me just the other day, she says, stop acting like a flamingo. So I had to put my foot down. That was terrible. That's a bad dad joke right there. Okay. All right. The next award, y'all, this is going to be exciting, is Business Professional of the Year Award. The Business Professional Award was created to honor individuals in the Spanish Fork Salem area that have demonstrated an exemplary level of leadership and community engagement to positively impact the quality of life in the area. This award is voted upon by the entire membership of the chamber. David, are you going to pronounce this one? All right, the mic is yours.
So we've had a great time working with this individual for a while. When we sat down as a board to try and determine who was deserving of this award, this name came first and it stayed there, and it was voted on, and I appreciate all that this person does. A couple of the things that he has done is he's helped a lot of small businesses. During the time of COVID with marketing, helping them design marketing programs, helping them design other things to grow their business at the same time, all while still running his business with over 60 employees. Jesse, we'll present this to Jesse Carden.
Congratulations, brother. That's amazing. All right, we got another award. Surprise. Here it is, Legacy Business of the Year Award. This is going to be great because the last year that the Chamber started a new tradition of recognizing a business that has had staying power, longevity, and the ability to adjust to the changing economic climate. Have we had any changes lately? Yeah. So this is a big award, and I'm going to have my friend David Rowley go ahead and announce this one as well.
So this business has been here in Spanish Fork as long as I can possibly remember. Not quite in the same building, but they have been a staple here in Spanish Fork. Serve Daily did a report, did an article on them not long ago, and it hangs, part of it hangs on the freezer in the produce department. I know because I work there in the produce department. I'm glad to have this gentleman here with us, Bill Summers, if you'd come forward. Our legacy business is Macy's.
Congratulations, Bill. We love Macy's. He's been here a while. I love that. That's amazing. All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're coming upon the new award here is Community Action Award. Taking action in the community. The Community Action Award honors the partnerships and organizations that leverage their resources, expertise, and talent to make a positive impact in the community. Jesse, I'm going to have you go ahead and present this one now.
All right, so this business, I think a lot of you will recognize that this business has made sure to, since they've opened in 2018, to make sure that they do everything they can to give back, especially to our servicemen and women. They give discounts, they do a free service every Veterans Day for those who have served or are currently serving our country. And I believe if I remember correctly, because I forgot my paper, it was, how many veterans this year? A lot. 130 veterans received free services on Veterans Day. Just barely, they teamed up with other barbershops in the area to get supplies for a fellow barber whose family was in Tonga and was affected by the tsunami that happened. It's my pleasure to award the Community Action Award to the Fellows Chop Shop.
That is awesome. You know, my father, Alan, he trained for Vietnam. Grandpa George, who I'm named after, Army Sergeant, World War II, great uncle, Pearl Harbor survivor. And as an honorary command sergeant major, I thank you for all you do for our troops. One more round of applause. That's awesome. I love that. Oh, man, I get choked up when I get patriotic. This is fun. All right. Emerging Business of the Year Award. The Emerging Business of the Year Award is given to a business that has contributed to the economic vitality in the community and demonstrated an unusual faith in the future business climate of the Spanish Fork and Salem area. The business must have operated for less than 5 years and be a member in good standing of the Spanish Fork Salem area Chamber of Commerce. Randy, would you please come and tell us who deserves this award?
So There we go. All right, so I'm honored to present this award to Compassion Mobility. They opened their doors just this past year. I'm gonna read what I wrote because it's just gonna be easier that way. So Compassion Mobility opened their doors in 2021. In such a short time, they have made a huge impact in the chamber and in our community. On top of running a thriving business, Tanya delivers meals to Wheels on Meals, to the seniors of Spanish Fork, volunteers on weekends at events that involve people with disabilities, and has recently joined our chamber board of directors to share her talents of marketing to expand the vision and mission of the Spanish Fork Chamber of Commerce. As Tanya and Robert continue to take the mobility industry to a new level, they will make sure that everyone is invited to come along on the ride and continue to be the pioneer in their industry while being true examples of how to successfully merge your passions of your business with your community. So, Tanya, Robert.
Congratulations. This is so wonderful. I love to see award ceremonies. It's nice to be recognized, isn't it? And I know you don't do it for the recognition, but that's what's so nice about it, that somebody recognized your efforts. And one more time, congratulations. The Neebles School District Partner in Education Award will be presented by Lana Hiskey, District Community Relations Specialist. Lana, the stage is yours.
You really are.
Yeah. Mic drop. Here we go.
Awesome. Thank you. Love it. Well, we're really excited. As you know, we couldn't have a great school district and education without partners and business partners, such as many in here. In fact, many of you have made a significant difference in the lives of our students. Tonight, we would like to honor Creative Signs and Graphics as our Business Partner of the Year. I'll tell you just a little bit about them. Bryce and Natalie Taylor have been with this business since 2015. They've been instrumental. I don't know how many of you have been to our outdoor athletic facilities at either Salem Hills High or Spanish Fork High, but the nice big video board that you see the scores and the video, well, that came from Creative Signs, and they have been very good to work with, and they're going to be doing three more schools, Payson High, Maple Mountain High, and Springville High, so we're really excited about that. So thank you so much. Also, they've just been very involved, even on the school level. Just a few years ago in 2019, Spanish Fork Junior recognized you as Business of the Year as well. For just stepping in, you give of your time, talent, and treasure, so thank you so much. They've been involved with branding and graphics and signs for the Nebo Education Foundation Golf Tournament. They help us every year without fail, and we really appreciate that. Recently, in the pandemic, we had a two-day turnaround time to get signs put up in our schools. We have 45 buildings. Creative Signs was also instrumental in getting those signs turned around and so we could have signs in our buildings. Creative Signs and Graphics. Was started back in 1999 by Brad Ford. Some of you may know him. He was a student of mine in business, and he's the only student that as a sophomore convinced me that he should take a senior class in business. And it was not a bad choice. He took that class as a sophomore, he excelled in business, and then opened Creative Signs. It was in the back room of Mountain Land Foods. Many of you know Doug and Carol Ford. He was a great graphic designer as well. He tragically passed away in a flying accident, February 12th, 2011. Carol and Doug Ford bought the business from his wife. They wanted to create a legacy And what was really cool about that is in 2015, his first cousin, Bryce and Natalie, bought that business. And I want you to know that Brad would be so proud of what you've done with this business. I think it's exceeded even his expectations. So you've done such a wonderful job. I knew I couldn't get through this. Bryce and Natalie have been running it, and they love serving in the community of Spanish Fork. And they had a groundbreaking, was it a year and a half ago? Hopefully we'll be in this summer. They're hoping to be in their new building. They do everything from decals and banners to digital signs and billboards. And if you've got a logo, they can do it. So look them up. If you'd come on up, thank you, Creative Signs and Graphics, for being an incredible business in education and for your part with the Salem Spanish Fork Chamber of Commerce. Yeah.
Congratulations, man. I love this. You guys loving this?
Yes.
Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. I'm loving it. All right, I got another great award here. I'm gonna bring a family friend back up here to the stage because the Spanish Fork Mayor's Award will be presented by former Mayor Steve Lafson and Mayor Mike Mendenhall. Let's bring them on up. Oh, sorry. Oh, my bad, sorry.
You got the speech?
I'm not talking.
Well, you know, we have a lot of awesome people that serve in our city. And we got an individual here that just retired after 37 years of service. Chief Adams, when he heard that I was going to not run again, he decided he'd retire. So. But he has been awesome. 10 years ago, we were looking for a new chief. And so we interviewed a lot of individuals, and there was no question who the chief was going to be. He was way above everybody that we interviewed. He was well respected by his fellow officers. He was prepared. He'd arrived through the ranks, through the police force, and he was ready to serve. So we not only appointed him as chief of police, but he was a public's safety director, so he was in charge of the firefighters and our EMTs. So he took on a big role, and he oversaw the new fire station that we built up on Canyon Road, and helped develop our full-time ambulance crew. So he has had his hands in a lot of things. He introduced a lot of things. The honor guard, he got Nick used in all our Nick cans. Is that how I say it, right? In all our police officers' cars. So when they came upon someone that overdosed, they were able to help save them and get them where they need to be. He started our public safety night, where all the kids and families could come to North Park, where all our police officers or firefighters and that were involved there. He was feeding them hot dogs, and our kids would come and they'd get in the cars, they'd run the sirens. They got to experience what it was to be by a police officer and help build trust in those young men and young kids to know that the police officers are there to help them and to serve them. He also got police radios in all our schools, and which was huge. So, and we had resource officers in most of our high schools and middle schools, and so he was instrumental in a lot of that.
And he did a lot of training, and he also did that with the mayor and the council. He took us up to Finger Hut one time, and we drove the cars probably way too fast, and he showed how we did that. And he also took us up to Dugway and did the same thing and showed what it was actually like when something went wrong. And so, talk to me after that, and I'll tell you what happened there. But, and then probably the best thing, we were up at Canyon View Park, and they brought people from three or four cities, officers, and they had real-life simulations of events that was happening, and they had each one of us do that. I remember mine was knocking on the door at a family dispute and walking in there, and a husband and wife, and they're screaming, and he finally picks up a knife and goes after her to stab her, and you're there as in the situation, what do? You know? And so these individuals have to do split-second timing and decisions are life-threatening. So it was awesome. So it helped me understand what they go through. You know, it's really easy for these people to criticize these police officers for the decisions they make, but when you're right in the moment, it's split decision, and he's trained his officers well, and so they know what they need to do. And the other thing that happened last year, Spanish Fork was the safest city in Utah and the 11th in the nation. That is a pretty amazing. That is. So, Chief has been responsible for a lot of that. He was nominated of the Patrolman of the Year. He was also the Police Chief of the Year last year. And he's had a lot of honors. And it's my honor and Mike's honor here to present this award to Chief Steve Adams, one of my best friends.
Standing ovation, brother. You deserve that. That's amazing. Thank you to all of our first responders out there for all they do for us. Right now, we're going to present the Legislative Action Award, which will be presented by Senator Mike McKell, Senate District 7, longtime Spanish Fork business person and resident. Let's welcome him up here, Mike McKell.
So the truth is, my guest is not here today, and that's okay. And this award is going to go to Deidre Henderson. And we have a lot of great leaders in our community, and I appreciate all of them. It's fun watching the chief up here. It's fun watching the two mayors. I get to see them every year on Capitol Hill, and it's remarkable the amount of collaboration and work that we have with the city. So thank you, Chief, as well. But I first met Deidre Henderson. Brian Chapman, raise your hand. Brian Chapman and I, Brian, I talked to Brian. I said, you know what, I'm thinking about running for the legislature. And I heard about this lady across town. She was thinking about running for the legislature. So we met at Magleby's Fresh about 10 years ago. And after about 2 minutes, I realized, okay, she's running for the Senate for sure, and I'm going to run for the House. And at that point, we formed a strong relationship. I wish people could see how hard she works on Capitol Hill. I promise you, if she didn't have a second round of COVID, she would be here today. Last week was a little rough for her. She showed up on Monday for a few hours and like, you know what, Deidre, just, it's okay, go home. Big projects that we work on, she called me, she said, Mike, we've got to get water down in Blanding to the Navajos that live across the gorge. And she takes me down there, and I returned the favor this last week. We've got some big projects down here. I said, Deidre, we've got some big projects here. I need your help. And the first thing she said is, how can I help? I wish she was here. She is a remarkable person to serve with, and it's my honor to award this to Deidre Henderson. I'm gonna let you give it to her. I can. But I'll take care of that. But thank you. If you could give her a round of applause, I'll tell her you cheered really loud.
Go Deidre. She is awesome. You know, it's been an honor. Thank you for letting me be your MC here tonight. I've had a blast and just so great. Anytime I get to come to Spanish Fork, this is where my parents will be laid to rest someday in this town. My grandparents are here. There's so many special people here in this town. And I tell you this, I had the opportunity, speaking of awards, I was totally caught off guard, but 2 years in a row, how many of you ever read a book by John C. Maxwell? You ever read Maxwell's book? We got a lot of leadership here in this room. I figured you probably have read some of his books. But 2 years in a row, I was presented with that award. And I tell you, he asked me, he says, Nathan, I want you to create a video to talk about what leadership is. And so I said, okay. So I put together a nice, big, long speech about leadership. And then he had us all meet together with him. And he says, this to me is what leadership is. It summed it up in one phrase. Leadership is influence. And that's what I see here in this room. My grandmother Osmond was a great leader, and she started a foundation, maybe you've heard of it, called the Children's Miracle Network. It's raised over $7 billion for children's hospitals. And on her deathbed, she was in a coma. She came out of this coma. My father was sitting by her side. She grabbed his hand. She couldn't talk because of a tracheotomy. She asked for a pen to write something down. And my father handed it to her. And she says, in her writing, we have this letter. It says, Alan, there is no limit to the good we can do if we don't care who gets the credit. She had to come back to tell us that. I'm so grateful that she did, because she lived that way and you live that way. Can we give one more big round of applause to all the influence in this room, the leaders? Thank you for your leadership. We love it. Appreciate that. Right now, we just want to thank the Chelan Reception Center here. That was a wonderful meal. Thank you. Give it up for those hardworking young ladies and men back there. I love that. Whitney Ferguson, Chamber Administrator. Come on, Whitney. Woo-woo. And all right. Randy Kaufman in the house. Let's give it up for Randy, Board Chair. And, of course, Jesse Carden, past Board Chair. Thank you all for being here tonight. There's one more page on here, brother. Looks like we're wrapping this up. It says, we got more to thank. Did you guys enjoy that dinner entertainment? Wasn't that awesome? All that acapella music. One more hand for Salem Hills High School Choir and Justin Bills, their director. And all who spent time working on this event, we thank you. And those who received awards, we want to thank you for all that you do here in our area. And it says there's another presentation from David.
So Nathan and I are good friends. We've known each other for about a year or more. I asked him to come and work here with us and MC this, and he didn't even blink. He didn't think twice. He said, what time, what day, and I'll be here. He does love Spanish Fork, even though he moved to American Fork. He still loves it here. And we thought, what could we do for him that would be nice? We got him a copy of Spanish Forkopoly.
Nice! Yes! Woo! Come here, let's take a picture.
You're awesome.
Thanks, everyone. Thank you for this. This is awesome. Woo!